Hello! How to perfectly match concept art and 3D model. When you have concept art of a front or side view, it's easy enough to match them. But it's much more difficult if your concept art is slightly rotated. I will show you my tricks, which helps me a lot in work. This is what the final result will look like. This will be a long one, but bear with me. I will guide you through every step. Step 1. Let's start by preparing our concept art. Open it in Photoshop. First, go to the Filter drop-down menu, then Stylized and Find Edges. We have an outline of our concept art. Now let's make it black and white. In the Image drop-down menu, find Adjustments, Black and White. Don't change anything, press OK. Or you can just desaturate it with Saturation in Hue Saturation. It will work either way. And finally, we need to invert it. In the Image drop-down menu, once again find Adjustments and invert. Good! If your lines are very thin and light, it will be a good idea to add more contrast. So in the Image drop-down menu, Adjustments, press Brightness Contrast and play with the settings to make lines brighter and cleaner. Step 2. I want to keep only white lines on a transparent background. First of all, let's copy the image you made. To select everything, press Ctrl plus A, and to copy it, press Ctrl plus C, and hide this layer by pressing the eye icon. Next, press on this thingy and choose solid color. We want the white color. And now let's paste our image into the mask. To do that, hold Alt and click on the mask. Next, press Ctrl plus V to paste the image, and click back on the white color to exit the mask editing mode. And done! We have white lines on the transparent background. Save image as PNG. I use Save for Web to make sure that Blender can use this image. I had some problems with PNG saved in the different way. So press Ctrl plus Shift plus Alt plus S and save PNG. Step 3. Open Blender, delete everything. And let's hide the timeline, as we don't really need it right now. Hold your mouse over this divider line, press the right mouse button and choose Join Areas. I like to have my concept art and camera screen left, so move your mouse over the corner so that it becomes this cross shape and drag it. And repeat that one more time. Now on the bottom screen, change the editor type to Image Editor and open your original concept art. Step 4. Setting up the camera. Press Shift A and add a sphere and the camera. Drag your camera a bit to the side and go to its settings. My models are usually for orthographic games, so I change the camera type to orthographic. Then check the checkbox next to background images and press Add Image. Finally, open your PNG with the white lines. Very important to set the depth to the front and the frame method to fit. Now in the top left view, press on the camera icon, then N, View, and in View Lock, check the Lock Camera to View checkbox. Thanks to this, we can rotate the camera and set it as we like. If you need to zoom orthographic camera, then use the Orthographic Scale slider. Aim the camera roughly at the sphere and start sculpting your character. Adjust the camera angle as you develop your character. And if you manage to find the perfect angle match, don't forget to uncheck the Lock Camera to View checkbox. It will lock the camera and you won't be able to move it accidentally. Yeah, that was a lot of steps, and I totally understand if that's too much. But this extra camera helps me a lot, so I really wanted to share my setup with you. And this is the final textured model.